Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. In this session, we will see a very simplest test circuit for UC384x 243445. It is set up four ICs. Most of the time when we are working, when we are repairing these power supplies, because it is a very common IC which is being used in different circuits, battery chargers, in power supplies, it is used for flyback and boost converters, feed forward converters. In this session we will see its test circuit. When we apply voltage at pin number 7, it will provide 5 volt reference. We will take this 5 volt and we will connect to 10 kilo ohm resistor and 3.3 nano capacitor, and the common point of these two components will connect it to pin number 4. Here we have this transistor and a resistor. When we connect these two components, this IC will start to make ramps, sawtooth waves, in this way. Using this transistor, we allow conduction. This is a 5 kilo ohm potentiometer, and we take a taped signal and provide to I sense pin, current sense pin, that is this one. When we apply current sense signal, at that time it will adjust its duty cycle to limit the switching. And then we have 4.7k two resistors and 1 kilo ohm potentiometer to adjust the feedback voltage, that is here. We can see it is adjusting its duty cycle from 0% to 100%. When we are using these two components, 10 kilo ohm resistor and 3.3 nano capacitor, at that time its switching frequency is 4.49 kilohertz. When we are using UC3843 IC, and when we will connect UC3844 and 45 ICs, at that time the frequency will drop. Why? Because for 44 and 45 series there is a toggle flip-flop to reduce the duty cycle. So at that time the output frequency will be half than the oscillator frequency. You can make on any project board, any Vero board. Here is pin number 7. We are applying supply voltage to pin number 7, and I connected 1 microfarad 50 volt capacitor between pin number 7, and this pin is connected to pin number 5, that is ground. At pin number 8, I connected 104J 0.1 microfarad or 100 nano capacitor, and both capacitors, center end, is connected to ground. As I shown in this diagram, this capacitor reference pin is connected to capacitor. 7 number pin is connected to capacitor. Here I showed 100 nano, but physically I am using 1 microfarad capacitor, that's no problem, that's same. I connected 1 kilo ohm resistor at pin number 6, so that I connected a load resistance and I take output voltage across this resistor. This is ground pin. Pin number 5 is grounded. Pin number 5 is connected to ground, and this reference voltage, 5 volt reference, it will reach to this 4.7k resistor, and this 4.7k resistor is one end is connected to this potentiometer. In the second end we have another resistor, it is connected to also ground. We connected a resistor, it is connected to center pin of this potentiometer, 1 kilo ohm potentiometer. And the potentiometer is connected to pin number 3. Pin number 3 is connected to this current sense circuit. One end is grounded of this potentiometer, center pin is connected to pin number 3, and the emitter of this transistor. Here I am using 2655, you can use 2N2222A. any NPN transistor. It is connected to, emitter is connected to this pin, and collector is connected to reference voltage. This is collector pin, center pin collector. So we connected a resistor, 10 kilo ohm resistor, between the reference pin and pin number 4 of this IC. At pin number 4 and ground, we connected this capacitor. This is 3.3 nano capacitor. I will attach the diagram of this circuit in the video description so you can test it. Here I am using 15 volt ground supply. You can use 10 volt, 12 volt, any common supply you can use for testing. I am connecting the ground of oscilloscope low side to the ground, and test point is connected to the channel A. And here I am using multimeter, so you can use any multimeter to test the frequency. Multimeter low side here, and this one is here. It is giving 49 kilohertz. Because here is 3.3 nanocapacitor and 10 kilo ohm resistor, so output frequency will 1.72 divided by RT CT. RT, that is this 10 kilo ohm resistor, and CT, the timing capacitor, that is 3.3 nano. So output frequency will 52 kilohertz, that is ideal. But when we select components, most of the time the value of the components is with tolerance. In that condition, the frequency is now 49 kilohertz. Here is current sense signal. So when we increase the current sense signal, when we increase the current sense signal at that time, this IC will limit its duty cycle. And when we adjust the feedback, it will also adjust its duty cycle. This is the feedback signal which we normally connect with the optocoupler. It is increasing its duty cycle up to maximum limit. This is maximum duty cycle, we can say 98%, and this is the minimum 0%. From 0% to maximum. This is 3843 IC. Let me connect 3842 IC. I am connecting 3842 IC. I connected 3842 IC, and now I will connect. So here we can monitor the duty cycle. It is using 95% duty cycle. When I will decrease the duty cycle, it is changing the duty cycle. 10%, 6%, and then 0. Because it is using dead time. So in this way we can verify the frequency. Okay, let's change some other IC. I will use 3845. Just install the socket. When we use 3845, at that time it will use 50% duty cycle. 3844 and 45, these two ICs have internal toggle. At that time the oscillator frequency is 50 kilohertz, 52 kilohertz or 50 kilohertz, as we discussed in the formula. Oscillator frequency is 50 kilohertz, but the output frequency will drop up to 25 kilohertz. Why? Because this IC have internal toggle to provide 50% duty cycle. If I will set to frequency 25, set to duty cycle, now it is using 34%, And if I will decrease the duty cycle, we can see it is coming narrow, but if I will increase the duty cycle, it will reach up to 47.8%, 48%. This is for flyback operation. For discontinuous mode, so in discontinuous operation it will provide this off period. For that purpose, if we need 50 kilohertz at that time, we need to set the oscillator frequency at 100 kilohertz. This RTCT combination, using this tester you can test this IC in very simple ways. If you have any multimeter which can measure the frequency, you can use it. Just only apply power and verify the function of this IC, so it will a good addition in your workshop. Let me connect another IC. It is 3845. I will use 3842. You can see this IC is not providing any ramp signal. Why? Ground and reference voltage, we don't have any reference voltage. That is pin number 8. That means this IC is damaged, its internal regulator is damaged. 3844 and 3845 have 50% duty cycle. 42 and 43 100%, 02 98%, 99%, but this one is limiting its duty cycle up to 50%, and the output frequency is 25 kilohertz, because 3844 and 3845 have half frequency than the oscillator frequency. We have ground, PWM output from pin number 6, VCC and reference voltage. Reference voltage are routed to this resistor, this collector and this resistor. 4.7k two resistors, in between there is 1 kilo ohm potentiometer to adjust the feedback signal. We are providing 2.5 volt reference with increasing or decreasing option to adjust the duty cycle to view the IC function, and here we are limiting the current sense pin. We are providing 1 volt to this pin to limit the duty cycle. When we will increase the signal up to 1 volt maximum, at 1 volt this IC will turn off its function, so we can check it very easily. I hope so this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.